think Quincy.
From this day forward, till death parts us, or until you become a fan of anyone other than the Lightning.
The wedding ring is the symbol of the covenant that these two make today. Note the configuration. It is circular. It is a symbol of eternity. God's love for these two is never ending. It has no beginning. It has no end. Luke's left hand. Now repeat after me as you do so. Dustin, I give you this ring.
Dustin, I give you this ring.
As a sign of my vow.
As a sign of my vow.
It is officially on.
It's on.
He gained weight.
Now that Kimberly and Dustin have given themselves each to the other by solemn vows, with the joining of hands and the giving and receiving of rings, I announce to you that they are husband. Dustin, if you are so inclined, you may kiss your bride.
Oh, oh, he's not going to do
that.
I thought he'd bend her back. And...
Here they are. Mr.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's my pleasure to introduce to you at this time, Mr. and Mrs. Dustin Keene.
Yay!
Yay! Yay, yay, yay!
There they are, Mr. and Mrs. Keene. Oh yeah, you need that. She needs the bottle.
Here, can I drink yours?
Yeah.
Look at the babies, all sleeping, puckered out.
That was for me.
She's making sure. She's doing that poison test, right? If she's okay.
And it was a full glass one over though. Oh, something's ever changed.
The babies.
Are you vlogging right now?
I am.
Vlogging about how beautiful I am?
That's what I was just about to say.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
That's right.
Daniel.
Hello.
Give me a kiss.
Perfect. It's Aunt Donna.
No.
Yes.
Did you cry?
Why would I cry? It's like no big deal. Ah, just psych. I got emotional. I mean, they just love each other so much.
Their vows were really good.
Yeah. They've got away with words. That's what I was asking earlier. Did you know they were going to do the funny thing with the hockey stuff?
With the hockey stuff?
Where they were saying things in referencing hockey.
I didn't know Dustin, but Kim practiced her speech on me, and then I wrote it on the nice paper. So, I knew.
So you knew. It was funny.
To begin with a traditional toast. To
my God.
The very proud father of the groom, everybody, to do our first toast. Most of these speeches start out with the best man talking about fun times and good times and all that. But fortunately, I get the privilege of being the father of the groom and the best man. Thank you, I'd like to thank Guy Quincy for putting on this fabulous, fabulous event.
Yeah, here, here. Sorry, I had to clap.
Dustin and I go back a little way. Changing diapers and then taking the first breath. I can't tell you how it feels. As a father, to stand up there and tell you how proud I am. I don't know if I get this out. Anyway, you're a lucky guy to find someone like Kim. I think I told you one time. You'll know it when you find it. You'll just know it. And I think you found it. Kim, when he came to me the first time, a little over a year ago, and said, I'm going to ask Kim to marry me. And I was like, you haven't known her long enough. What? How can you say that? And he told me. When you know it, you'll know it, and I know it. And from that moment on, when you walk in the house the next time, I know it. You made the right choice. It was awesome. You guys are the greatest living couple. Everything's going to be good from here on out. I couldn't congratulate you more from the bottom of my heart. I just feel blessed to have all of us here together to celebrate this. And that's all because of you guys.
Can we do a toast? Steady.
You didn't even toast, I was just listening to champagne. I
haven't even. Thank you so much. Guys, one more hand. That's not an easy task.
No.
Thanks for making me cry again. Tim, thanks for making me cry again. Tim, thanks for making me cry again. Tim, thanks
for making me cry again. Tim, thanks for making me cry again. They are all signing the shells. It's kind of like a sign-in when you sign the shells.
I think you need to tilt it.
That's cool. Aww, I'm gonna do one.
Sorry.
That's what you probably need to lean on a little bit.
Yeah. And I was trying to like drop it gently so it didn't break, but.
Oh my god.
It's like a thing, like I'm gonna put a picture on it.
Yes. And it was my girlfriend's idea. I can't write with this. Here.
That's a bug.
Like, why can't I write? Am I retarded? I'm gonna answer that. There, I got it. To the cake. Wow. I'll take that in. That's gorgeous. Did you see this yet? It's gorgeous. I gotta say it like that. Gorgeous. Wow, those are really pretty. Who got you those? God. Huh? It's Kim. Put her hand up. Da-da-da-da-da. Hey. God, that is just gorgeous. It looks fake. This whole table is pretty.
Oh, look.
Oh, look. When I got engaged. Oh, I'm gonna cry again. Oh, look, it says Dustin and Kimberly. That's not the real Tamblyn Bay logo writing. Copyright protected. Cool, huh? Squeezes. If we start a fight with these things like, you know, food fight, hockey puck fight, will you be upset? Thank you. of worship. No, I want you to go meet her right now.
There's three things.
Come on.
You know, just want to let you know, boss, that it is tradition that you feed a piece of your wedding cake to your bride, and she'll feed one to you now. But wait a minute, Dustin. Be careful, bro. This is one of those career decisions you're about to make here, bro. All right? Be careful. Tell me, man. Somebody's going to yell, smash her, and I'm telling you, those are usually the single ones, brother. And with that said, ladies and gentlemen, they're cutting. I think I'm going to recognize Richard Harrell and his beautiful wife, their photography out here tonight, folks.
Yeah.
They've been here all day shooting. And Steve, our video producer. It's Steve Spielberg. All right, ladies and gentlemen, here they go. They're preparing bite-sized pieces. Serve here throughout the evening, but right now we'd like you to